Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on what is MDS on HEMI engines. MDS stands for Multi-Displacement System. MDS technology essentially allows these HEMI engines to shut down 4 of the 8 cylinders on the engine and ultimately results in better fuel economy and lower emissions. The way in which it technically works is actually reducing pumping losses within the engine. So when you are cruising and maintaining a steady speed, the throttle plate is barely open to make a little amount of power, and that leads to a lot of pumping losses within the engine. So shutting down 4 cylinders and turning the V8 HEMI engines into essentially V4s actually allows that throttle plate, the throttle body, to open further and reduces pumping losses by having less valves moving and operating. The point is, it's really the pumping losses that allow for the lower emissions and better fuel economy when we talk about cylinder deactivation technology like the HEMI Multi-Displacement System, or MDS. So, how does HEMI MDS actually work then? Again, it really comes down to reducing pumping losses. So in theory, you would think shutting down 4 cylinders would be as simple as cutting fuel flow and cutting ignition to those 4 cylinders, but that would not reduce pumping losses since you would still have a very minimal amount of air moving through the engine, the throttle plate still wouldn't open very far, and you would still have the intake and exhaust valves operating on the cylinders even though they're not igniting or creating any power. So ultimately, for multi-displacement system to actually work, you do actually have to keep the intake and exhaust valves closed. HEMI relies on a couple different things to essentially accomplish this and allow the intake and exhaust valves and those push rods to remain shut and not move. It all starts with the ECM, or the car's computer. The first step in the process is the ECM will cut fuel flow to the 4 cylinders. It's cylinders 1, 4, 6, and 7 on the 5.7 and 6.4 HEMI engine that are shut down when MDS is activated. It is always those same 4 cylinders. Those cylinders will still move through one more 4-stroke cycle. So the intake valve will open for a final time and then close, where it will remain in a shut position while MDS is activated. At that point, the engine will again continue the 4-stroke cycle, so you'll have compression. And then on the combustion power stroke, remember, fuel supply has already been cut to these cylinders, so there will not be any actual ignition or any power during the power stroke. And then finally, the exhaust valve opens for its last time before shutting. And so the ECM is responsible for controlling all of this, the whole process of the ECM cutting fuel supply and shutting all the valves, and this whole process working generally takes about 1/10 of a second. It can be a little bit longer depending on RPMs. So it is very quick, a snap of the finger, and all of this is taken care of. MDS is activated, but keeping those valves shut does require a couple extra pieces of technology on the engine, the MDS solenoids. The solenoids send highly pressurized oil to a pin inside the lifter rollers, which actually then allows the lifter roller to follow the camshaft profile. While it does that, the motion isn't actually transferred. So basically, that allows, again, the lifter roller to follow the cam profile without actually having the push rods engaging or those intake and exhaust valves opening or closing. So ultimately, that's the basics for how HEMI multi-displacement system technology works. Looking at benefits of HEMI MDS technology, again, the main benefits are lower emissions and better fuel economy. It's roughly an improvement of 10 to 20% better fuel economy while MDS technology is engaged. Tying into those two benefits, that's really what allows some of these larger engines like the 5.7 and 6.4 HEMI to meet the much stricter modern emission standards and still be able to be large, high-performance V8 engines. Moving on to a couple downsides of multi-displacement systems. Number one, there are more components to fail, unique lifters for MDS to actually operate, as well as 4 MDS solenoids. So it really just adds more moving pieces and more complications to the engine, so it can reduce reliability. Another thing is MDS, again, always shuts down those same 4 cylinders, and while they're shut down, especially for extended periods of time, that can lead to poor lubrication for those 4 cylinders, as well as those cylinders operating at cooler temperatures. So it can cause some long-term reliability issues, potentially. Obviously not great if things cool down too much and suddenly you need to stomp on the gas, all the cylinders kick back to life at high power after they've been been shut down and allowed to cool for an extended, say, highway drive. Speaking about reliability, some of this has been seen on HEMI engines with MDS technology. Lifter roller failure, as well as issues with the valve seats, have been seemingly much more common on HEMI engines equipped with MDS compared to HEMI engines that do not have this technology. And this also extends to other brands and other manufacturers who use similar cylinder deactivation technologies. GM with their AFM or active fuel management is a good example. A lot of those vehicles have also seen higher rates of failure with things like the lifters due to likely the AFM system. So it is interesting that a lot of these vehicles that do have cylinder deactivation technology seem to have more problems within the cylinder head and specifically the lifters than vehicles without this technology equipped. Outside of that, sometimes HEMI MDS can feel a little clunky. It should be pretty seamless. However, at times it can feel a little clunky, and that is one thing that people tend to complain about, is that it just feels a little clunky, a lack of response, or it just doesn't feel as smooth or natural as it should. So with that said, that brings up another topic which a lot of people look to do, and that is disabling the multi-displacement system technology. There are a couple different ways to accomplish this. On HEMI-equipped vehicles, most of them will actually allow you to manually disable or deactivate the MDS system, but you'll have to do this every time you get in the car to drive it again, and so it's a little bit of a hassle if you want to continue turning off MDS. Another way to do it and keep MDS always disabled and always shut down is via tuning. With tuning, it's very simple to just not engage the MDS system. So a tune, if you are looking to tune your vehicle, that is one great way to disable MDS. And then finally, the most expensive route and one way to completely delete MDS technology is by actually upgrading the camshaft. Upgraded camshafts often don't have any MDS technology. It's actually very rare to see any aftermarket HEMI cams that offer MDS technology. Ultimately, a camshaft upgrade is a great way to do that, and that completely deletes the specific lifter rollers. You can get solenoid block off plates, and so you can effectively delete the entire MDS system with the camshaft upgrade route. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.